worship the God who was. We worship the God who is. We worship the God who evermore will be. He opened the prison doors. He parted the raging sea. My God, He holds the victory. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today, and we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place, and we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. We shout out your praise. God who heals, we sing to the God who saves, we sing to the God who always makes a way. Cause He hung up on that cross, and He rose up from that grave. My God still rolls His stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord, there's joy in the house of the Lord today. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. We shout out your praise. Shout out your praise. We were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Now we're royalty. We were the prisoners. Now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place.
Shine. grip on me. You have broken every chain. There's salvation in your name, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Oh God, you are my living hope.
St. John Nepomucene Catholic Community, and thank you for worshiping with us today. It is reassuring to note that the disciples do not react with immediate joy when they first encounter the risen Christ. Their response, instead, is to be startled and terrified. We too do not always react with the wholehearted joy when we encounter Jesus. He often comes to us in unexpected ways and asks for us for sacrifices we don't want to make. But Jesus' response is to offer reassurance. He has the disciples look more closely, showing them the wounds he endured on the cross and eating in front of them to reassure them that he is not the ghost they fear he is. Jesus responds to our hesitations with the same reassurance. He always invites us to come closer, to see more fully who he is and what he is doing. And when we do, when we finally see him well enough, our response will echo the disciples' amazement and joy.
Please stand for our gathering song.
Exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him. He is exalted forever, exalted and I will praise his name. He is above for
Let us gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
As always, the saving grace of Jesus, the love of God our Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Father Ron wanted me to tell you that he's doing very well at this time. He wants to thank every one of you for your prayers, your blessings, and all of your thoughts. But he's probably watching on the YouTube. And so, in appreciation, just know that he thanks every one of you. And maybe in a couple weeks, he'll be back with us. But he's healing well, and he's working hard on his knee recovery. And so we just wish him the best. And so, like the disciples on the road to Emmaus, let our hearts burn within us as we hear the gospel and celebrate the Eucharist.
Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you heal our troubled hearts. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. So may the Lord have mercy on all of us, forgiving us our sins and bringing all of us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
And we praise God in song.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of
Let us take a moment and pray, each individually, pray in your own way, just for this moment. So let us all pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit. so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope in the rejoicing of the day of resurrection through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
At this time, we invite our little ones to come forward for the children's liturgy. I just invite everybody to raise your hand as we pray for these little ones. Heavenly Father, may you open up their hearts to hear your message today, to know of your love for them, to know that it's okay when you're afraid, that even the apostles were afraid sometimes. But when Jesus was with them, he helped them to feel better. He helped them to not be afraid. And so we pray for you as you go forward to hear his message.
Children go to hear God's word. Children go to hear good news. Children go with joy to hear God's word. Children go to hear good news.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he has announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that as Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me. O my just God, you who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine.
O Lord, Let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to my dwelling. A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see that I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked bread, or baked fish, and he took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So we are well into this season of Easter, this time of celebration, a time when we remind ourselves over and over again of just how special and just how important the events that took place a few weeks back are to us. As Christians, if there's no resurrection, we don't have a faith. So Jesus died for our sins, and he rose from the dead so that we could have eternal life. And that's really the basis of our faith. And as we hear in our readings today, there's a mission that we are called to, that we are to take that message and to pass it on. We hear in our first reading, it starts out as a condemnation of the people for putting Jesus to death. But then it kind of quickly moves into a conversion, a call for repentance, a call back to God. Again, a reminder that Jesus died for our sins. And we are called to repent and to follow him. And then in our second reading, we hear more of the same. And we're also encouraged by the fact that we have an advocate, that Jesus, in his death on the cross for us and his rising, has become our advocate, has become our connection back to the Father. And that, again, if we repent of our sinfulness, that he has opened that pathway to heaven for us. We hear in Luke's gospel today the story of the night of the resurrection. And we heard John's version of it last week. This week we hear Luke's version. The two men that were on their way to Emmaus and experience and encounter Jesus, they're back in the upper room where all the apostles had gathered. They were afraid. They didn't know what to do. And these two disciples come and start sharing with them all about their encounter with Jesus on the road to Emmaus. But they just couldn't believe it. They just weren't sure. And then all of a sudden, Jesus himself appears to them. And they're still a little bit afraid. Is he a ghost? Is he a hallucination? What's going on? And Jesus says to them, "Peace be with you." And he invites them to touch his wounds. And he asks for a piece of fish to eat. And as he goes through all of that, he slowly begins to help them understand that that he is real, that he is there in front of them, that he truly is resurrected. And their fear gradually gives way to joy and to happiness. And once Jesus was able to remove the fear, he was able to help them understand the scriptures. He was able to open up their hearts so that they could know what his message was and to know what his mission was, which was to share this Easter message, this message of salvation, this message of Jesus dying for our sins and then rising for our new life. Through our baptismal promises, we're called to that same mission, We're called to share that Easter message. And guess what? There's a lot of fear in our lives. Our world is a fearful place. You know, we fear that our kids and our grandkids aren't happy or maybe struggling with something. You know, we fear for our jobs sometimes, or are we doing good enough? We fear for the things that are going on in our world. You know, we wait sometimes in fear for the results of a medical test, or for fear of a procedure coming up. Everywhere we look in our world, there seems to be the potential for fear. How do we overcome that? We can't control fear. We can't run from it. But how do we overcome that? The simple answer is Jesus. Jesus, he overcame the fear that the disciples had, that the apostles had. And he overcomes our fears as well. Because unless we can overcome that fear, then it becomes almost impossible for us to go out and to share that good news, to share that Easter message. So we have to allow Jesus to enter into our hearts. We have to believe without a doubt that he did what he did, that he died for us, that he rose from the dead for us. So that when we take that message and we go and share that, we're doing so with passion, with commitment, with conviction. We can't do that with fear. Jesus needs us. He's counting on us. He's counting on us to bring that message to the world, to everyone that we meet. He's counting on us to be the hands and the feet and the eyes and the ears. He's counting on us to encounter people so that he can work through us, that he can talk to people through us. The number one way that we experience the risen Christ is through one another. And none of that happens with fear. It's a great time of the year. This time of springtime is a time of life. It's a time of new growth. It's a time of just life and energy and all things wonderful in creation. We look outside, or we sit outside, we hear the birds singing and the trees are budding again. And you know, all of God's creation is coming to life and is bringing forth new life. And for almost all of creation, that's sort of dictated and determined by things like the temperature or the amount of daylight in a day. All these things react to those natural things that go on in our world of creation. When to build a nest, when to spawn, you know, when to bring buds forth. All of that's determined by things. But we're different. People are different. The number one thing I believe that influences our actions and our activities is each other. Do you think about it? Every time you want to make a major purchase or go to a new restaurant or see a new movie or try a new spot for vacation or whatever it might be, what's the first thing we do? We talk to our family, our friends, our neighbors. Hey, do you know anything about this place? Have you been to see this movie? We go online, we do research, we look at things, we read the reviews, we see what people say about it. And then we make our decisions about the activities in our life, sometimes based on the opinion of people we don't even know. In order for us to carry this message to others, we have to be able to get over the fear. We have to be vocal. We have to speak with them, because we understand that we are each other's biggest influence. And if we can share this Easter message with other people, we don't even have to know them. But if they see Jesus in us, then we truly can make a difference. Then we truly can lead others to Jesus. His resurrection gives our faith meaning and purpose. Without it, we have nothing. He calls us to share that message. So I invite for us to be bold and to set aside our fear, to reach out to Jesus and say, calm my fears. Help me to overcome them, so that this person or that person or somebody that we know that we need to be talking to, that we need to be sharing this Easter message with, can hear that message from us, that can hear that message from Jesus through us, so that they can respond, that they can be filled with his love, that they can know that they have the promise of eternal life.
Let us rise, and instead of the Nicene Creed, we have the renewal of our baptismal vows and promises, because during the entire Easter season, we have that opportunity to express our faith in the risen Lord as we pray together through the Roman Missal, please. Deacon Dave and I then will come around and bless you with the Easter water. Please sign yourselves. It's your opportunity to express your faith in the risen Lord. Brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and the prince of sin?
I do.
And it concludes with the beautiful expression of our faith. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed upon us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Thank you for holding this big book. You're such a nice guy. We are going to come around now to bless each of you. Just sign yourselves as you are blessed with the Holy Easter water.
River of glory, springs of our earth, blood of God's riches, born on the earth. We are born from the darkness, clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God. Fountain of mercy, grace flowing free, streams of salvation.
Now, accompanied by the glorified Christ, let us entrust our needs to God, who hears all of our prayers.
That the Church be ever thankful for the gifts of the earth and the graces that flow from the real presence of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Inspire religious communities to live out their mission in our ever-changing world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in need, that they may find the guidance and assistance from the many ministries and services made possible by the bishop's appeal, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open our mind and hearts to the divine word proclaimed through the scripture, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this congregation, united in love and service, be perfected in the love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters who have died, especially Danny Hsu, that God raise them up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in our hearts, for those in our assembly prayer book, and at this Mass, we remember Bob and Arlene Calloway. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, you call us to be people of peace, who live out the lessons of Scripture in our words and in our actions. Receive our prayers, that strengthened by Jesus, we might be witnesses of his glory to all people, all nations. We ask this through Christ the risen Lord. Amen. Let us rise and pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her, your church, cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Now, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Then lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let all of us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ Jesus, our Passover, has not only been sacrificed, but risen from the dead, through him, the children of light rise to eternal life. And the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown wide open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and by his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they with us acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font, like the baptismal font. And after this, we're going to have a few children, babies, baptized at the baptismal font. So too, we who have been baptized, send your Holy Spirit now upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of your own beloved Son. Now, at the time when Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. He blessed it and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he, Jesus, took the chalice. And once more to his heavenly Father, giving thanks, he then gave the chalice to his disciples, saying to them, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and his resurrection, we offer you, Lord, our Heavenly Father, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence to minister to you. So humbly we all pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we all may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. So remember, Lord, your church spread here and throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Bishop David Ricken, our Bishop, Father Ron, our pastor, Deacon Dave, and all of our deacons, all the clergy. And tomorrow, when the bishop comes here to celebrate Mass, and all will be gathered to celebrate with the bishop, we all come together as one. So remember also all of our own brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Then have mercy on all of us, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse and husband, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
rise. And to the Father, at the command of Jesus, we now pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord Father, from every evil, and graciously grant peace on our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we all await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, when you rose from the dead, the first gift you gave them was your gift of peace. And you said to them, peace be with you. My peace I give to you. We ask, Lord, that you not look on our sins, but that you look on our faith and grant to each one of us peace now and peace in life to come, where we shall live forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
So the promised peace of Jesus be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our Lord.
For those that cannot be here today and are joining us from home, we pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Oh, what a Savior! your cross as you wait for the crown. Tell the world of the treasure you found.
Let us rise and let us pray.
The body of Christ.
Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord. And grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The announcements. Join us this Wednesday for our monthly parish breakfast at 7:30 a.m. in the Fellowship Hall. Our guest speaker will be Father Bert Ebbin. All are welcome. Come and join us this Thursday anytime between 1 p.m. and 7 p.m. for a time of quiet adoration held here in church. The Divine Mercy Chaplet will be also led at 3 p.m. Please note that the Knights of Columbus will be holding their Tootsie Roll Drive next weekend after Mass. Calling all students in 5th through 8th grade, Fire Camp sign-up will end on Monday, April 15th. See the bulletin for more information on how to sign up and enjoy a fun-filled day helping out in the community, enjoying Spiritus activities, lunch, and then Mass. We are also in need of many high school and adult helpers as well.
So the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Lord himself bless each one of you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
Saint Michael, the Archangel,
defend us now.
Be our
Savior
against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the divine power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Jesus' blood and righteousness.
Savior's love. Dressed in his